Hi friends, this is Manikanta Prasanna Kumar. Welcome to my channel Maths with Money. You can follow me on my Facebook page Maths with Money. Regarding myself, I cleared RRB NTPC and also SSC CGL, and I am selected as Customs Inspector in CGL 2017.
Hi friends, welcome to the video of SSC CGL 2019 mains questions explanation. We already covered the topic algebra. Now we will discuss the topic trigonometry. So basically from the trigonometry, total 29 plus 3 questions, 29 from trigonometry particularly and 3 questions from heights and distances are asked in total 3 shifts of 2019 mains exam. Okay, we will cover all these 32 problems in 3 parts, 3 or 4 parts. Okay, maybe 4 parts, heights and distance I will tell you in another part or in the last part of the trigonometry or also. Okay, so in the first part we will discuss the first 10 problems of the trigonometric ratios. Okay, so but before that we will take or we will revise some of the formulas on trigonometry. Okay, let's see. So already in the trigonometry most of the problems will be or can be solved using the substitution method. What is substitution? By putting the value of theta as 0 degrees or 30 degrees or 45 or 60 or 90. These are the specific angles. Yes. So using that substitution, you can solve most of the problems in trigonometry. But some of the problems can be solved using the process or using some of the formulas in trigonometry without substitution. Okay. If you use substitution, it will take more time than the using the formula. That's why you have to know some of the formulas in trigonometry. Let's discuss. So first one, like we have to know some of the values of specific angles. Okay, for suppose it is like there is a table which we already discussed in the trigonometry concept itself also. Like 0 degrees, 30, 45 and 60 and 90. These are the specific angles. Okay, so sine and cos and tan. If you know these values, inverse of these values representing the cosecant and secant and cot. Okay, sine 0 is 0, sine 30 1 by 2, 45 is 1 by root 2, sine 60 root 3 by 2 and sine 91. Reverse of these values are cos. So 1 and it is root 3 by 2 and it is 1 by root 2 and it is 1 by 2 and it is 0. Yes. Next, what about tan? Sine by cos, 0 by 1, 0. And 1 by root 3 and it is 1 and it is root 3 and it is infinite. Okay, when you when we use substitution to solve some of the problems, please remember, for suppose in the question only sine and cos trigonometric ratios are there. In the question, for suppose sine theta into some cos theta, something like that, only sine and cos are there, then use theta as 0 or 90. You can use 0 or 9. Okay, first suppose in the question tan or cot or secant or cosecant, out of these 4 any one trigonometric ratio is there in the question itself, then you have to take most probably theta as 45 degrees. That is the best option to choose. Our best specific angle you have to substitute. Is it clear? So whenever out of these 4 trigonometric ratio, any one trigonometric ratio is there, use theta as 45. In the question, if sine or cos, only sine and cos are there, then use theta as 0 or 90 degrees. Then most of the problems can be solved. Okay. And coming to the formulas, okay, we have some of the identities. What are the identities? Sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. From that I can tell you sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos square theta. Sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos square theta. 1 minus cos square theta can be written as 1 plus cos theta into 1 minus cos theta. Yes. Similarly, what about the other identities we have? Secant square theta minus tan square theta equal to 1. From that I can tell you secant square theta equal to 1 plus tan square theta, or tan square theta equal to secant square theta minus 1. And one more thing here that is most important for our exams. It is in the form of a square minus b square. So I can write a plus b into a minus b. That is secant theta plus tan theta into secant theta minus tan theta is equal to 1. So from that I can tell you secant theta plus tan theta is equal to what? 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. Yes sir, 1 by secant theta minus tan theta. Similarly, what is the value of secant theta minus tan theta? 1 by secant theta plus tan theta. This is most important identity. Okay. And some other formulas, like another identity. What is the third identity we have? We have cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is equal to 1. Implies a square minus b square equal to 1 means a plus b into a minus b. Same. Here I can write cosecant square theta equal to 1 plus cot square theta. And also a square minus b square means cosecant theta plus cot theta into cosecant theta minus cot theta equal to 1. So what is the value of cosecant theta plus cot theta? 1 by cosecant theta minus cot theta. Just we have to revise these formulas because while solving the exam, okay, before the exam also we have to revise the trigonometric ratio formulas or geometry formulas or algebra formulas. Okay, it is must. Okay, and next thing we already discussed it, 1 plus secant theta plus tan theta. 1 plus secant theta plus tan theta into 1 minus of cosecant theta minus cot theta means 1 minus cosecant theta plus cot theta is always equal to 2. I derived this formula. Okay, I derived this. Just write down sine as 1 by cos and tan as sine by cos, cosecant as 1 by sine and cot as cos by sine. Then you can easily derive this formula. This is also very, very important. Okay. Next one is like complementary angles. Whenever alpha plus beta, sum of two angles are 90 means those two angles are complementary. Tell me what about the complementary trigonometric ratio for sine? What is the complementary trigonometric ratio? Cos. What about for tan? It is cot. What about secant? It is cosecant. Okay. These trigonometric ratios are complementary to each other. Whenever sine alpha equal to cos beta is given, then alpha and beta are complementary. That means alpha plus beta is 90. Okay. Suppose what about sine 33? In terms of cos, it is equal to 57 because 33 and 57 are complementary. Okay. We solve many problems regarding these type of questions, related to these type of questions. Okay. So these are some of the basic formulas which you have to remember while solving any problem in trigonometric ratios. And we have some other formulas also, but I am not dealing about all the things. These are some of the basics. Using these values, how do you solve the questions related to mains levels or mains level exams of SSC? Okay, let's start the video. See the first one. The value of cosecant square 30 degrees, sine square 45 degrees plus secant square 60 by tan 60 into cosecant square 45 minus secant square 60 into tan 45. Here in the question, all are specific angles. So without taking any substitution, you have to substitute the direct values of those specific angles. Okay. Cosecant 30. Sine 30 is 1 by 2. So what is the value of cosecant 30? 2. 2 square. That is 4. Sin square 45. Sin 45 is 1 by root 2. So 1 by root whole square means 1 by 2 plus secant square 60. Cos 60 is 1 by 2. So what is the value of secant square 60? It is 4. By tan 60 root 3. Cosecant square 45. Cos secant 45 is root 2. So root 2 whole square means 2. Minus secant square 60. Same 4 into tan 45 is 1. So let's see. The calculation, 2 ones, 2 twos, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 by 2 root 3 minus 4. So 2 to cancel j and cancel with the term 2, 2 ones, 2 threes, 2 ones, 2 twos. So what is the answer? 3 by root 3 minus 2. 3 by root 3 minus 2 is the correct answer. But if you observe the options, there is third in the numerator, not in the denominator.
But root 3 minus 2, you can take the rationalizing factor, that is root 3 plus 2 r. In the Savart-Sung indices, I told you, whenever there are any consecutive numbers like 2, 2 means 4, root 4, root 3, okay, or root 3, root 2, like that, okay. Whenever root 4 plus root 3 is there, I can directly write down it as 1 by root 4 minus root 3. Or 1 by root 4 minus root 3 is nothing but 1 by root 4 plus root 3, which we already discussed in the Savart-Sung indices concept. So that's why in place of root 3 minus 2, 2 means root 4, okay. So I can directly write it as 3 into, since here root 3 minus 2 can be written as minus of 2 minus root 3. Yes, minus of 2 minus root 3. 1 by 2 minus root 3 is nothing but 2 plus root 3. Okay, here minus is there, so minus. So minus 3 into 2 plus root 3, which option it is? Which option it is? First option, sorry, first not. Fourth option is the correct answer. Yes, fourth option is the correct answer. Minus 3 into 2 plus root 3. Is it clear? So here the combination of trigonometric ratios with Savart-Sung indices. Okay, next. I hope all of you understand. Next, second one. Sine theta into 1 minus tan theta into tan theta plus secant square theta. The total sine theta is multiple for all the total value of this. Okay. And this tan theta is only multiple for 1 minus tan theta. By 1 minus sine theta into tan theta into 1 plus tan theta into secant theta plus tan theta. Okay. What is the answer? So I can use substitution, but here tan or secant or cosecant or cot, any one of the trigonometric ratio is there, I have to take theta as 45. So substitute theta as 45. Sin 45 1 by root 2. 1 minus tan 45 is 0. So tan 45 is 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 0 into anything, 0. Plus secant square theta. What is the value of secant? 45. Root 2. Root 2 whole square means 2. So this is the numerator. What about the denominator? 1 minus 1 by root 2. 1 minus 1 by root 2. Write down the next step of 1 minus 1 by root 2. 1 minus 1 by root 2 means after taking LCM, I can write this as root 2 minus 1 by root 2. Okay. Into tan 45 is 1. Tan 45 is 1. 1 plus 1, 2. Here tan 45 is 1. Here tan 45 is 1, but already 1 is there. So 1 plus 1, 2. And tell me, secant 45 is root 2 and tan 45 is 1. So root 2 plus 1. Clear? 1 by root 2, here 1 by root 2 cancel. 2, 2 cancel. And what about the numerator? 1. By denominator, root 2 plus 1 into root 2 minus 1. A plus B into A minus B. These two are nothing but they are multiplicative inverse to each other. When two numbers are multiplicative inverse to each other means their product is 1. So what about the denominator? 1. So 1 by 1 is 1. So first option is the correct answer. That's it. Is it clear? Okay. You can solve this problem without substitution also. Here multiply tan theta here. 1 into tan theta. Tan theta minus tan square theta plus secant square theta. But secant square theta minus tan square theta is 1. So what about the numerator? Sin theta into 1 plus tan theta. Already here 1 plus tan theta is there. 1 plus tan theta cancel. So sin theta by 1 minus sin theta into tan theta. And secant theta plus tan theta. It is nothing but 1 by secant theta plus tan theta. It can be written as secant theta minus tan theta. So you can proceed like that also. But using substitution, you can solve the problems of trigonometry. That's why most of the problems we will discuss in this video are through substitution only. Okay, next one, that is third one. Yeah, cos A into secant A minus cos A into cot A plus tan A. In the question, we have tan, cot and secant. So definitely we have to take the substitution as 45. So if I take A as 45 degrees, if I take A as 45 degrees, tell me if I take A as 45 degrees, cos 45, 1 by root 2. Yes, what about secant 45? Root 2 minus 1 by root 2 into cot A plus tan A. What is the value of cot 45, tan 45? 1, 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. So tell me root 2 into root 2 to LCM 2 minus 1. So 1 by root 2. So 1 by root 2 again 1 by root 2 into 2. So root 2 into root 2, 2, 2 cancel 1. So what should be the answer? 1. So when I substitute A equal to 45 in the options, the answer should be 1. So cot 45 is 1, tan 45 is 1. So since two options are there, definitely we can't take A as 45. Yes or no? So is it clear? So whenever two options are satisfying the same answer, definitely we can't take A as 45. Okay. Now what is the procedure? Or you can take A as 30 or A as 60. But when we have tan and cot are there, 30 and 60 means root 3, 1 by root 3 are there. Okay, let us take A as 30. Then I can tell you how the answer should be. If I take A equal to 30 degrees, for suppose. Cos 30. Cos 30 is equal to how much? Root 3 by 2. And again, secant A minus cos A. Secant A means secant 30. Secant 30 is 2 by root 3 minus cos A, that is root 3 by 2 into cot 30 is tan 60, that is root 3, and tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So tell me root 3 by 2, take LCM 2 into 2, 4 minus root 3 into root 3 means 3, 1 by 2 root 3 into root 3 into root 3, 3, 3 plus 1, 4 by root 3. So tell me 2, 2 cancel, that is 4, 4, 4 cancel, root 3 cancel, 1 by root 3. When I substitute A equal to 30 degrees, the answer should be 1 by root 3. So secant 30, 1 by root 3, no. Cot 30, 1 by root 3, no. Sin 30, 1 by root 3, no. Tan 30, 1 by root 3, yes. So what should be the answer? Tan A is the answer. But here, two substitutions are taken place to solve the problem. When two substitutions are taken place means it is better to solve this problem without substitution and follow the formulas or follow the trigonometric ratios. That is easy. Is it clear? How? I will tell you. Let's see. Wait. I will erase this total thing, then you can easily understand. Okay, without substitution, how we will do this? Because some problems can be solved using direct formulas. Okay, or I'll solve this in the next phase. Okay, let's see. Here I will write down once again cos A into secant A minus cos A into cot A plus tan A. Just multiply each and everything. Cos A into secant A, that is 1. Cos A into cos A, cos square A. Cot A into tan A. Cot and tan write down as sin cos. Okay, sin A by cos. If you know the trigonometric ratios very well, in the concept itself I told you, cot A plus tan A can be written as 2 sin 2, sorry, 2 cosecant 2A, or I can directly write down this as 1 by sin A cos A. If you know very well, you can write down. Otherwise, I will tell you how it is equal to 1 by sin A cos A. Sorry, what is the value of cot A? Cos A by sin A. Yes, cos A by sin A. And what is the value of tan A? Sin A by cos A. 1 minus cos square means sin square A. Okay. Take LCM cos A into cos A. Cos square A plus sin A into sin A. Sin square A. What is the value of cos square A plus sin square A? 1 by sin A into cos A. So sin A, 1 sin A cancel. So sin A by cos A is equal to tan A. This is simple. And here only two steps are required when you know without any trigonometric ratios formulas. Otherwise, it is a single step. How? Cos A into secant A 1, cos A into cos A, cos square A, 1 minus cos square means sin square A. Write down it as in a single step. and cot A plus tan A in the trigonometric ratios initial starting of the trigonometry, I told you like that this value is 1 by sin A cos A. So sin square A into 1 by sin A cos A. Directly you can write down this step by eliminating this step. Yes, so easily you can write down as tan A. Okay, so some problems can be solved using substitution and some problems can be solved using just writing the formulas. Okay, I hope you understand both the things. Next, let's see the fourth one. If sin A equal to cos of A plus 10, sin A and cos are complementary trigonometric ratios. So definitely sum of these angles is equal to 90 because they are complementary. So 3A plus A plus 10 is equal to 90. So 3A plus A, 4A is equal to 90 minus 80, that is 80. So what is the value of A? 20 degrees. What is the value of A? 20 degrees. Next, what he was asking, what is the value of 2 cosecant 3A by 2 plus 6 sine square 3A minus 3 by 2 tan square 3A. So substitute the value of A here, then you will get some of the specific angles. So 2, 3A by 2, A is 20, so 2 once 2 10, so 3 into 10, 30. So 2 cosecant 30 plus 6 sine square 3 into 20, 60. Minus 3 by 2 tan square 3 into 20 60. So tell me 2 into cosecant 30 means 2, 2 into 2 4. Sin square 60 means 3 by 4, 6 into 3 by 4 root 3 by 2 whole square. Minus 3 by 2 into tan square 60 means root 3 whole square means 3. So 2 3s, 2 2s. 3 into 3 9 by 2, 3 into 3 9 by 2. So both get cancelled. So what is the remaining value? 4. Option B is the correct answer. Okay, just apply the complementary trigonometry complementary angles formula and from that find out the value of A and substitute the value of A in the question, then you will get some of the specific angles and find out those values. Okay, that's it. Is it clear? Next, we'll go to the next one. Fifth, 1 by cos theta minus 1 by sin theta plus 1 by cosecant theta minus cot theta minus 1 by secant theta plus tan theta. This problem can be solved using substitution. Since here cosecant cot are there, definitely theta is 45, and using general procedure. General procedure is also very easy. Tell me 1 by cos theta. I'll tell you first general procedure. 1 by cos theta means secant theta, yes, minus 1 by sin theta means cosecant theta, very good, plus I told you 1 by cosecant theta minus cot theta is equal to cosecant theta plus cot theta. In the starting of this video we discussed some of the formulas, yes, minus of 1 by secant theta plus tan theta can be written as secant theta minus tan theta. So tell me here secant theta cosecant theta cancel, and cot theta minus of minus tan theta, that is tan theta. So cot theta plus tan theta. I already told you in the previous problem, cot theta plus tan theta is what? 1 by sin theta into cos theta. But here all the formulas are related, not in the numerator, not in the denominators. They represent only numerators. Denominator should be 1. So 1 by sin theta can be written as cosecant theta, and 1 by cos theta is represented as secant theta. So cosecant theta into secant theta, that is first option is the correct answer. Okay, is it clear? This is general procedure. Otherwise, since the tan cot are there, theta should be 45. If I substitute theta is 45, theta 45, 1 by cos theta, that means root 2. 1 by sin theta root 2, both cancelled out, plus 1 by cosecant 45 is root 2, cot 45 is 1. So 1 by root 2 minus 1 is nothing but root 2 plus 1, because 2 and 1 are consecutive natural numbers, minus 1 by root 2, secant 45 is root 2, tan 45 is 1. 1 by root 2 plus 1 is nothing but root 2 minus 1. Now both are zeros. And root 2 cancel, 1 minus of minus 1, that means 1 plus 1, 2. So when I substitute theta is 45, option should be 2. Okay. Let's see which option. Theta 45, secant 45 root 2, cosecant 45 root 2, root 2 into root 2, 2. So it may be the option. Sin 45, 1 by root 2, tan 45, 1. 1 by root 2 into 1 means 1 by root 2. So it is wrong. Cosecant 45, root 2. Cot 45, 1. Root 2 into 1, root 2. It is wrong. Sin 45, 1 by root 2. Cos 45, 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 into 1 by root 2, 1 by 2. So it is also wrong. Only option satisfying is first option. So that is the correct answer. So in this way, you have to solve this problem. I hope all of you understand this, both the methods. Okay. సో ఫ్రెండ్స్ చిన్న స్మాల్ బ్రేక్ అనుకోండి దీంట్లోని. బేసిక్గా నేను మెన్సురేషన్ 3D కి పెయిడ్ కోర్స్ అనేది చెప్పడం జరిగింది, 500 రూపీస్. ఇట్స్ టోటల్ కన్సిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ 44 వీడియోస్. ఓకే, ఈ 44 వీడియోస్లో మనకి కాన్సెప్ట్, తర్వాత ఇన్స్క్రైబింగ్ ఫిగర్స్, నెక్స్ట్ ప్రాక్టీస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్, నెక్స్ట్ ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్, ఇలా ప్రతిదీ టాపిక్ వైజ్గా డిస్కస్ చేయడం జరిగింది. సో మెన్సురేషన్ 3D అనగానే మనకి ప్రిజమ్స్, క్యూబాయిడ్స్, క్యూబ్స్, సిలిండర్స్, పిరమిడ్స్, కోన్స్, స్పియర్స్, హెమిస్పియర్స్ అండ్ రిమూవల్ ఆఫ్ సాలిడ్ ఫిగర్, అంటే ఒక సాలిడ్ ఫిగర్ నుంచి కొంత రిమూవ్ చేయడం కానీ కట్ చేయడం కానీ ఉంటాయి కదా, ఆ టాపిక్స్, రేట్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లో, ఇంక్రీజ్ ఇన్ వాటర్ లెవెల్, రిమూవల్ ఆఫ్ ఎర్త్. రిమూవల్ ఆఫ్ ఎర్త్ అంటే ఒక దగ్గర మట్టి తీసి ఇంకో దగ్గర వేస్తే ఎంత ఎత్తు పెరిగింది ఇట్లా అంటాడు అన్నమాట. ఇలాంటి మోడల్స్ అన్నీ కూడా మనం ఒక టోటల్ 44 వీడియోస్లో చెప్పడం జరిగింది అండ్ టోటల్ 323 ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ని మనం ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేసాం నియర్లీ 44 అవర్స్. సో ఈ కోర్స్ ఎవరైతే పర్చేజ్ చేయాలనుకుంటున్నారో వాళ్ళ కింద స్క్రోల్ అవుతున్న వాట్సాప్ నెంబర్కి మీరు మెసేజ్ చేయగలరు. సో మెసేజ్ చేస్తే మీకు నేను క్లియర్గా ఇన్ డీటెయిల్గా ఏం ఎలా కోర్స్ పర్చేజ్ చేయాలని చెప్తాను. అదర్వైజ్ యూ కెన్ వాచ్ ద వీడియో హౌ టు పర్చేజ్ ద కోర్స్ ఆఫ్ 3D మెన్సురేషన్. అలానే సర్కిల్స్ కూడా మనకి కోర్స్ ఉంది, ఇట్ ఈస్ 200 రూపీస్, టోటల్ 20 వీడియోస్ అండ్ దాంట్లో కూడా మనం చాలా క్వశ్చన్స్ అనేవి ప్రీవియస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ అండ్ ప్రాక్టీస్ క్వశ్చన్స్ డిస్కస్ చేసాం. ఎవరైతే ఈ కోర్స్ తీసుకుంటారో ఈ కోర్స్లో చెప్పిన ప్రాబ్లమ్స్కి PDF కూడా మీకు విత్ కీ అనేది ఇవ్వబడ్డ జరుగుతుంది. ఓకేనా? సో ఇఫ్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ డౌట్స్ రిగార్డింగ్ దీస్ కోర్సెస్ ఆర్ ఎనీ PDF, యూ కెన్ మెసేజ్ మీ ఇన్ వాట్సాప్. లెట్స్ గో టు ద మెయిన్ వీడియో. సీ ద 6th వన్. ఇఫ్ సీకెంట్ థీటా ఈక్వల్ టు ఏ బై బి అండ్ బి నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు 0, దెన్ 1 - tan² θ / 2 - sin² θ. ఓకే, సో మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది స్టూడెంట్ సాల్వ్ దిస్ యూజింగ్ ద రైట్ యాంగిల్ ట్రయాంగిల్. సీకెంట్ థీటా ఏ బై బి మీన్స్ టేక్ ఏ రైట్ యాంగిల్ ట్రయాంగిల్ ఇన్ విచ్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఎక్యూట్ యాంగిల్ ఇస్ థీటా అండ్ సీకెంట్ థీటా ఇస్ గివెన్ యాజ్ ఏ బై బి. దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద జనరల్ థింగ్ రిగార్డింగ్ సీకెంట్. సీకెంట్ మీన్స్ హైపోటెనస్ బై ఎడ్జసెంట్. ఓకే, సో హైపోటెనస్ ఇస్ ఏ అండ్ ఎడ్జసెంట్ సైడ్ ఇస్ బి. సో వాట్ అబౌట్ దిస్? ఏ స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ బి స్క్వేర్ అండ్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ఫైండ్ అవుట్ ద వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ టాన్ స్క్వేర్ థీటా అండ్ దట్ ఈస్ 1 - వాట్ ఈస్ ద వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ టాన్ స్క్వేర్ థీటా? ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్ బై ఎడ్జసెంట్ సైడ్, ఏ స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ బి స్క్వేర్ బై బి స్క్వేర్ బై 2 - వాట్ ఈస్ ద వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ సైన్ స్క్వేర్ థీటా? ఆపోజిట్ సైడ్ బై హైపోటెనస్, దట్ ఈస్ ఏ స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ బి స్క్వేర్ బై ఏ స్క్వేర్ అండ్ టేకింగ్ ఎల్సిఎమ్ బి స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ ఏ స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ బి స్క్వేర్ దట్ ఈస్ 2b² - a² / 2a² - a² ఏ స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ బి స్క్వేర్ ఇంటూ ఏ స్క్వేర్ బై బి స్క్వేర్. ఓకే, దిస్ ఏ స్క్వేర్ గోస్ టు న్యూమరేటర్, సో విచ్ ఆప్షన్? ఇట్ ఈస్ 3rd ఆప్షన్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద జనరల్ మెథడ్ మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది స్టూడెంట్స్ విల్ ఫాలో ఫర్ దిస్ మోడల్. బట్ ఐ టెల్ యూస్ హియర్ ఆల్సో సబ్స్టిట్యూషన్. వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ సబ్స్టిట్యూషన్? ఓకే, వాట్ ఈస్ ద క్వశ్చన్? ఇట్ ఈస్ గివెన్ secant theta is equal to a by b and the question is 1 - tan² θ / 2 - sin² θ. I can take any value for the theta. Yes, first suppose if I take theta equal to 45, so what is the value of secant 45? Root 2. Secant 45 is root 2. Root 2 means root 2 by 1. So that means a represent root 2 and b represent 1. A represent root 2 and B represent 1. When theta is 45, tell me what about the question? 1 - what is the value of tan 45? 1. So 1 - 1 is 0. 0 by anything is 0. So if I substitute A equal to root 2 and B equal to 1 in the options, the answer should be 0. Okay. So let us take anything. It should be 0 means, since the numerator, if I have plus sign, since all are since all are squares, okay, definitely we can't get, zero. To get the value, to get the numerator value to be zero, definitely you have minus. So first two options to be eliminated, maybe first third option or maybe fourth option. Yes, so I'll start with third option. So what are the values I have to take? A is root 2 and B equal to 1. Tell me first, 2 root 2 whole square means 2 into 2b square. 2b square means 2 into 1, 2 minus a square. A square means root 2 whole square, 2. 2 minus 2, 0. 0 by anything is 0. So option C satisfied. Option D, if I substitute 2b square minus a square into b square, 2 minus 2, 0. Yes, that means both the options satisfies when I take theta as 45. Yes, so that's why I'll take another value that is the best value. Okay, what is that? Theta equal to 0. That is the best value. Theta equal to 0. When theta equal to 0, secant 0 is 1. 1 means 1 by 1. A and B both are 1. When theta is 0, 1 minus tan square 0 is 0. So 1 minus 0 means 1. 2 minus, what is the value of sine 0? It is also 0, 1 by 2. So when I substitute A and B are 1, the answer should be 1 by 2. A and B are 1, answer should be 1 by 2. Since A and B are equal, here also both the options are satisfied. Yes or no? Because A and B are equal, cancel. 2 minus 1, 1 by 2. Here also 2 minus 1, 1 by 2. Okay? Is it clear? So now I can take another thing. That is secant 30 or secant 60. I can't take secant 90. Yes, because it is infinity. Yes? If I take secant 30, secant 30 means, or secant 60, you can take secant 60 also. Secant 60 is 2. 2 means A by B. 2 means A is 2 and B is 1. A is 2 and B is 1. So 1 minus tan square 60, 1 minus 3, that is minus 2. By 2 minus sine square 60 is 3 by 4. So 4 2 is 8 minus 3, 5, minus 8 by 5. Secant 60, let's see. A is 2, okay, 2 square by 1, 4 into. You can take option C and D. No need to find out all the values for A and B. Option A, option B, they are already eliminated. Okay, so if I take option C, let's see. For option C, I'm taking, okay, option C, I'm taking A square is 4 by B square is 1. And 2 minus 4 by 2 square, 4 plus 1, 4 into 2 minus 4, that is minus 8 by 5. So that value you have to take, yes or no, minus 8 by 5. So what is the correct answer? Option C. But for the sake of option D, they are not correct, because B square means 1 by 4 into 2b square means minus 2 by 5. So the answer is minus 1 by 10. So it is wrong. So option C is satisfied. Okay. So here, which value you have to take? You cannot take all the three values as substitution. If you have practice, directly you can take theta as 60 and in the first substitution only we will get the answer. Option C or option D. Okay. Since here also minus is there. Okay, is it clear? But most of the students follow this method. In this method also you can get the problem in single step or two steps only. But if you want substitution, then the second method is preferable. Okay, so let's go to the seventh one, next one. Is it clear? Next. Yes, very very nice problem. The value of secant square theta into 2 plus tan square theta plus cot square theta divided by sin square theta minus tan square theta by cosecant square theta plus secant square theta into 1 plus cot square theta whole square. Okay. Here tan or cot are there. So definitely you have to take theta as 45. So tell me secant 45 is root 2. Root 2 whole square means 2. tan 45 cot 45 is 1. So 2 plus 1 plus 1 means 4 divided by sin square 45 is 1 by 2 minus 1. That means minus 1 by 2. Again, whole divided by cosecant square 45 is 2. Secant square 45 is also 2. 2 plus 2, 4. Cot 45 is 1. So 1 plus 1, 2 whole square means 4. So 8 divided by minus 1 by 2, not 8 into minus 1 by 2, 8 divided by minus 1 by 2 means 8 into minus 2, that is minus 16 by 16. So both get cancelled. What is the answer? Minus 1. Which option it is? First option is the correct answer. That's it. Next, through small substitution, 45. Next, 8th one. 8th one is very, very nice problem. Here, these are not the specific angles, but if you observe the angles, they are complementary angles. 2 sin square 38 into secant square 52 plus cos 64 into sin 26 plus sin square 64 by tan square 23 plus cot square 23 minus secant square 67 minus cosecant square 67. If you observe the numerator in the first thing, first term, 2 sin square 38 secant square 52. 38, 52 are complementary because 38 plus 52 is 90. Similarly, cos 64 into sin 26. 64, 26 are complementary. Yes, 64 plus 26 is 90. Similarly, 23, 67 are also complementary. So, you have to write down all the values as some single values. Okay. If I take 2 sin square 38, sin square 38 can be written as cos square 52. Into secant square 52. Yes, cos 52 into secant 52 is 1. So 1 into 2 is 2. So what is the first term of the numerator? 2. Okay, 2 plus cos 64 into sin 26. Sin 26 can be written as cos 64. Cos 64 into cos 64, cos square 64 plus sin square 64. Cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1. So what about the total sum of these two terms? 1, 2 plus 1. Divided by tan square 23 plus cot square 23 minus secant square 67 can be written as cosecant square 23. Yes or no? I'll erase this. Wait. I'll write secant square. I'll write down secant square 67 as cosecant square 23. And cosecant square 67 can be written as secant square 23. Why? Because 23 are there here. Now tell me, secant square theta minus tan square theta is 1. So what about the tan square theta minus secant square theta? Minus 1. Cosecant square theta minus cot square theta is 1. But here cot square theta minus cosecant square theta is there. So it is also equal to minus 1. So 2 plus 1 is 3. Minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. So what is the value of 3 by minus 3? It is nothing but minus 3 by 2. So option B is the correct answer. Is it clear? Next. Ninth one. The value of cos power 6 theta plus sin power 6 theta plus 3 sin square theta cos square theta by cosecant theta secant theta into sin theta plus cos theta minus 1. Into sin theta plus cos theta plus 1. Okay. Very simple problem it is. Okay. If you are good at trigonometric ratios. Okay. In the trigonometry concept I told you. Cos square theta plus sin square theta whole cube. Is equal to a plus b whole cube equal to how much? A cube, that is cos square theta whole cube means cos power 6 theta. A b cube, sin square whole cube means sin power 6 theta. Plus 3ab, 3 cos square theta sin square theta into a plus b. A plus b means cos square theta plus sin square theta. It is nothing but 1. So since this value is 1, 1 cube equal to this. So what about this value? It is equal to 1. So when you observe the question carefully, the numerator itself represents cos square theta plus sin square theta whole cube. So what should be the numerator? 1 by. Is it clear? Is there any doubt? Okay. Now here cosecant theta into secant theta into sin theta plus cos theta minus 1 into sin theta plus cos theta plus 1. I'll write down here. Okay. If I multiply cosecant theta with this term, cosecant theta with this term and secant theta with this term, tell me, cosecant theta into sin theta 1, cosecant theta into cos theta, that is you have to multiply these two terms, multiply these two terms, secant and this, and cosecant and this, cosecant into this term, cosecant into sin 1, cosecant into cot, okay, cosecant into minus 1, that is minus cosecant theta, okay, into secant theta into sin theta, that is tan theta, secant theta into cos theta 1, secant theta plus 1 into 1 is secant theta. We already discussed 1 plus secant theta plus tan theta into 1 minus cosecant theta plus cot theta is equal to how much? 2. So whatever is the denominator value? 2. So 1 by 2 is the correct answer. Option C is the correct answer. Without substitution, this problem can be solved using these two formulas. But when do you solve these models like this? Because of practice only, you can observe the numerator as a square a plus b whole cube, or in the numerator, in the denominator also it is in this formula. Okay, otherwise you can't do it this. Yes, since the question has secant and cosecant, definitely you can take the value of theta as 45 and you can have to solve using substitution. Okay, if I take substitution, let's see, theta 45, substitute theta as 45. If I take theta is 45 degrees, tell me, cos power 6, 1 by root 2, whole power 6 means 1 by 2 whole cube, 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8 plus 3 into 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, but that is 3 by 4, by cosecant 45 is root 2, secant 45 root 2, root 2 into root 2, 2 into sin 45 plus cos 45, 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 means root 2, so root 2 minus 1, again here root 2 plus 1. Root 2 minus 1 into root 2 plus 1 means 1. 1 into 2 means 2. So denominator is 2. 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8 is 1 by 4. 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4 is 1. So 1 by 2. So option C is a correct answer. You can solve in any method. But here observation is very important. By observing the numerator or the denominator, using the formulas also, you can solve this in the single step. Okay, next and 10th one, this is the last problem for this video. Let's see. If x is equal to secant 57, then cot square 33 plus sin square 57 plus sin square 33 plus cosecant square 57 plus into cos square 33 plus secant square 33 into sin square 57 is equal to. Okay. So here, if you observe carefully, here 33 and 57 are complementary angles, yes or no? Okay, I can write down all the 57 as 33, or I can take all the 33 as 57, convert into other complementary trigonometric ratio. But the best thing is convert 33 as 57, because the given value is secant 57. Okay, cot square 33 means if I want to write down as 57, it is nothing but tan square 57. Okay, and sin square 57 and sin square 33 as cos square 57 and cosecant square 57 means secant square 33 into cos square 33 plus secant square 33 means cosecant square 57 into sin square 57. Okay, sorry, it is cosecant square na, so okay, not to worry, you can write down this as cosecant square 57 only, and cos square 33 means sin square 57. Okay, tan square 57. Okay, tan square 57, I'll take 57 as theta because all are thetas only, na, tan square theta plus sin square theta plus cos square theta, it is 1, and cosecant square theta into sine square theta is 1, and cosecant square theta sine square theta is 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3. 3 can be written as 1 plus 2. And 1 plus tan square theta is nothing but secant square theta. So 2 plus secant square theta. What is the value of secant theta? That is, theta is 57, na? So secant theta is x. So secant square theta is x square. So 2 plus x square. 2 plus x square. Is it clear? Or any doubt here? Nothing. Yes. This problem can also solve using another thing. Okay. I'll tell you that. Here secant 57 is there, na? Given na x as. I'll take this as 45. I'll take this as 45. Okay. 57 is 45 and its complementary angle. What is the complementary angle for 57? 33. Yes. What is the complementary angle for 45? 45 only. So whenever in place of 57, in the question, if 57 is there, I can substitute as 45, and its complementary angle 33, in place of 33 also I will put it as 45. Okay. Now what is the value of x? X as secant 45. What is the value of secant 45? Root 2. So now x is equal to root 2, and the quotient becomes cot square 45 plus sine square 40 plus sine square 45 plus cosecant square 45 into cos square 45 plus secant square 45 into sine square 45. So now the quotient is with respect, now quotient has specific angles. Since it has specific angles, I can easily solve this. Tell me, what is the value of cot square 45? Cot square 45 is 1, sine square 45 is 1 by 2. Sin square 45 is 1 by 2, and again sin square 45 is 1 by 2, and cosecant square 45 into cos square 45 means 2 into 1 by 2, 1, and again sin square 45 into secant square 45, that is 1, 2 into 1 by 2, that is also 1. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, 4. So substitute x equal to root 2 in the options, you have to get the value as 4. So let's see. Root 2 whole square, 2 plus 2, 4. So first option may be the answer. 2 into 2, 4 plus 1, 5, it is wrong. 2 plus 1, 3, it is wrong. 1 by 2 plus 1, 1 by 3, it is all wrong. So only option satisfies first option. How that? This is the short trick. Okay. So whenever these things are there, definitely you can apply this type of angles also. That is specific angles. I hope all of you understand this concept, and you can apply this thing same models. Ilanti models vachinappudu meeru apply cheyochu. Okay, with this I'll conclude this session, and in the next session I'll tell you next 10 problems of the previous questions on trigonometry. Okay, all the very best. Thank you very much, and stay home and stay safe. Jai Hind.